In this video, we'll show you how to use the rearrange tool to optimize the sequence of your hat project so that you get the best possible production results. Suppose that this is a slogan that you want to embroider on a hat. For hat designs to get the best result, you need to optimize the embroidery sequence. If you start embroidering from left to right or vice versa, the result may not be as expected. To embroider on a hat, it is advisable that the embroidery starts from the inside parts to the outside or vice versa. Let's see how you can change the sequence using the rearrange tool. First of all, right-click on the lettering part and use the break apart option to separate the letters. The rearrange tool becomes available after switching from auto sequence to manual. Start the rearrange tool and click on the lettering part. You can see the automatically applied sequence, which in this case is from left to right. So this is the starting point of the design. Then it moves to the next one, and so on until it reaches this exit point of the design. Now, to change the order between the letters, click to select the letter in the middle, for example, and drag towards the object you want to be embroidered next. While dragging, a blue arrow appears, showing the direction of the embroidery sequence. Once the arrow gets inside the object you want, it turns red, indicating that you may release the object to apply the chains. A connection line is then added between those objects. Then from this character, drag to this one, then to that one, and so on. The connections between the characters appear with a red line. In this way, you can easily create your own sequence from the inner to the outer characters or vice versa with only a few drag operations. The order in the sequence manager is automatically updated each time you drag an object. If you start the slow redraw, you can see the updated sequence. The software automatically determines the best possible way to embroider each sequential letter and automatically adds the entry and exit points for each part. The green icon is the entry point of the object. It is the exact location where the first stitch of the object is to be placed. The blue icon is the exit point. This is the point where the last stitch of that object is to be placed. You may change the entry and exit points if the automatically determined position is not the one you prefer. To do so, simply hover over the entry or exit point and the cursor will change into a cross. Then click and drag the entry or exit point to its new position. That's it for now. Using the rearrange tool, you can do much more, like adding trims and stops. For more information on the rearrange tool, have a look at our other videos.